Hello, you guys. Today we talk about expansion tank cap. Basic function of the expansion tank cap is to limit maximum certain pressure in the cooling system. When the engine heats up, the volume of coolant is going to expand.
This type of cooling system is known as sealed cooling system, has a separate expansion tank.
This expansion tank cap needs to control the cooling system pressure.
Expansion tank cap is located at the front of the engine compartment. Expansion tank cap is connected by a hose to the radiator. If the engine overheats, coolant travels through the hose into the expansion tank.
When pressure increases, this expansion tank cap needs to allow excess pressure go out. For this function, this cap is provided with safety valve.
In this picture, you can see the safety valve. It's marked with number 3,
which opens at pressure 5 pounds per square inch on B18 engine or 10 pounds per square inch on B20 engine.
But we need to realize that expansion tank caps for B18 and for B20 engines are different. They differ not only in maximum pressure, but also in length and size.
When cooling system cools down, the volume of coolant is going to contract again. For this function, there is an anti-vacuum valve.
In this picture, you can see the anti-vacuum valve. It is marked with the number 2. The coolant is automatically drawn back into the cooling system to maintain the correct level. Coolant saved and reused.
This valve need to let coolant come back to its correct level when the cooling system cools down. Obviously, to relieve the partial vacuum that would otherwise occur.
Now at least we know what's going on with expansion tank cap. The level in the expansion tank varies with the temperature of the engine. When the engine is cold, the coolant level should be at or slightly above the cold full mark on the expansion tank. Once the engine has warmed up, the level should be at or near the full hot mark.
Unfortunately, over the years, the spring weakens, the rubber cracks. So, I bought new cap.
Yes, it says on the box that this is a radiator cap, but I didn't find the original cap. In dealer service department said that expansion tank caps are no longer supplied. Then I decided bypass that problem buying no original cap.
Global OEM supplier. Original?
Very beautiful protection sticker.
And it seems to me that this is a trusted supplier of spare parts. I really like this holographic sticker. Made in United Kingdom. Strange, of course, now on almost all expansion tank caps say that they are made in the UK. Let's open the box. Thanks for this sticker. We know that no one has changed the branded cap. Yes, I took it in my hands and I see that it is a really high quality spare part. Now let's compare our new cover with the old one. It's a good idea just for peace of mind. I can safely say that they are the same size. The main thing is that it fit inside. Good. It seems to me that the cap will make its functions. Here is the pressure for which this cover is designed. It also says made in England, so we don't forget. I dug around on my messy garage and I found a bunch of these old expansion tanks with caps. And incidentally, they're different. If you look well enough, you will see that the numbers are different. There will be different boiling points, 114 degrees Celsius for B20 and 107 degrees Celsius for B18. I want to check how the cap holds pressure. To do this, I connected a compressor with a pressure gate to the expansion tank. I apply air pressure to the expansion tank, and the pressure gauge shows that the pressure is increasing. Also, according to the pressure gauge, we see that the cap allows excess pressure go out from the expansion tank. When you check all cooling systems, do not allow the pressure to be too high. 7 pounds per square inch for B18 engine. Otherwise, system may be damaged. The pressure must not drop much in 13 seconds. 7 pounds per square inch for B18 engine. Cover is good. I made this mount for the expansion tank myself because the old one rotted. I need to add fresh antifreeze to the tank because the old one has boiled away. We can see that the tank is empty. I use blue antifreeze. On a cold engine, the antifreeze level should be a little bit above the minimum mark. I hope that with new cover, it will not be below the minimum mark. The pressure on the cover is 7 psi. This is for B18 engine. I have a B20. I think it's okay. For 10 psi, I bought another cap. It's unbelievable, but I put it for B18 engine. At any convenient time, I can change these covers in places. This green strip under the hose shows that the hose is not good fixed. In near future, I'm going to change this hose. Even a small leak is a loss of pressure, and pressure loss is a rapid hurting of the engine. And that can be very dangerous. Maybe someone will be interested, and here I'll give the part numbers of the old cooling system. Just
time I also bought a non-original cover. Here is its number. I buy non-original covers only because I didn't find the original ones.
If you like it, be sure to click thumbs up. Thank you so much for your time. Bye for now.